Hello everyone, well I'm on holiday again and another opportunity to look at a different washing machine. Because I don't collect washing machines like some of you, I don't have chance to show you very many different models apart from the ones I or members of my family own. So this is a rare treat for any of you who like washing machines. And the washing machine in question looks a pretty old model. It's behind this door. It's a built-in washing machine and here it is. It's a Zanussi built-in. You can't see very much of it at the moment, so I'll move my ugly mug out of the way and we'll have a look at the control panel and then I'll do a wash load in it. Well, the owners of this holiday cottage have left the instructions for me. It's a ZJ1217. I've no idea how old this machine is, so perhaps any of you washing machine experts out there would like to tell me roughly when this Zanussi model was available. Okay, it says it's on the back from the Electrolux group. It says 2001 on this actual instruction book. So I've got the instructions, so I'll know roughly what to do. But before I look at the instructions, we're going to have a look at the control panel. I think I'll be able to work out how to use it without using the instruction book referring to it. But anyway, we'll start with the drawer, work our way through the programs, have a look at the drum. It looks pretty small capacity. By the looks of it, it's just a washing machine, it's not a washer dryer. You might notice here it's got a little bit of discoloration. That's because there is a built-in oven right next to it, and I think that's what's caused this browning of the enamel finish. Also here is a magnetic catch which holds the door in place, obviously because it's a built-in model. That just connects with a little metal piece on the door. Okay, let's look at the control panel. Right then, starting with the drawer, quite clearly labelled, could do with a bit of a clean. We've got pre-wash, wash and fabric softener compartments, and you can actually remove it. There's a little push button. At the back, it's not too bad. I've seen far worse drawers than this one. Could do with a bit of a soak. The softener looks a bit gunked up. I'm not going to look inside there, I expect that's quite black. It does smell a bit, this machine. So what I'm going to do after I've done a load in it, I'm going to actually set it on the highest program, the hottest program, empty, with some detergent in, and give it a bit of a clean out. Right, let's just get this drawer back in. There we go, and let's have a look at the controls. Okay, first control we have is the on-off button, which you obviously press in. I can't actually see if that light's working. It might have gone. Often these little lights do fail. That, I would have thought that would have illuminated. The machine has got power to it, as far as I know. Let's just turn it, actually. It might not illuminate until I turn the dial at the end. No, it still doesn't illuminate, but when I do turn the dial, we've got the spin selector illuminated. So this controls your spin speed, obviously. So it's a maximum 1200. We could have a 900 spin, 700 spin, a 500 spin. If we don't want it to spin, we want to hold the clothes in the final rinse water with some conditioner. We can select rinse hold, and then when we're ready to spin the load, we can select a final spin. This obviously is pre-wash, which will give, obviously, as the name suggests, a pre-wash before the main wash. If you're sensitive to detergents and want an extra rinse for your clothes, and I think I will select extra rinse for this particular wash I'm going to do. So we can select extra rinse there. Soil level, that's something I've not seen before. So depending on how dirty the clothes are, we've got three different settings. Intensive, obviously for very dirty clothes. Normal, for just regularly soiled clothes. And quick, if they're just lightly soiled and you just want to freshen up the laundry. Now there's a bio function. I'll have to see what that does, but I assume you use that in conjunction with a biological washing powder. And then finally, we've got on this particular part of the control panel, we've got the start pause button. So obviously we press that to start the program and press it again if we need to pause it. Here's the main program selector dial on this Zanussi built-in washing machine. So we've got all the cotton programs here. So there's a 95 cotton, which is what I'm going to select to clean the washer out when I've done a load. There's a 60E, which I assume means economy. a regular 60 degree program, a 40 economy, a regular 40, a regular 30, and I'm assuming that this one could be just a rinse and fabric conditioner option. Then we've got your synthetics, again, a 60, 40, economy, 40, 30, and a rinse. Then we've got some delicate, 40 and 30. Then wool programs, 40, 30, and I'm assuming, again, that's rinse and spin, possibly. Now, we've got some special programs here. I might have to refer to the manual for those. But that one, not sure what that one is, so I'll have a look at that in the instructions. I'll tell you that in a minute. That seems to be a spin-only program. That must be to drain. If you've selected a program and you've made a mistake, we just need to drain the laundry. I'm assuming that you can turn the dial to that. That actually looks like a fabric softener program. Rinse and soften. So these ones could be spin-only, actually, these star-shaped programs. And again, there's two others here, and I'm not sure what they do. It's not self-explanatory by the symbols, so I'll just check. Fortunately, I do have the instructions, so I'll check those, and we'll see what those programs do. Okay then, this program that looks like a lightning bolt is what the instructions call a mini program. It says, this is a complete program that can be combined with the following options: spin speed, rinse hold. To be used for laundry which is lightly soiled or which needs freshening up. Maximum load 2 kilograms. The washing temperature is 30 degrees and it takes about 30 minutes for the program to complete. And it has a final spin speed of 700 RPM. So as I suspected, this program, symbolized by the flower, is a softener program, and that's for hand wash garments that can be softened using this program. So the machine will perform one rinse followed by a final spin at the maximum spin speed, but you can of course reduce the maximum spin speed of 1200 down to 500 if you've got particularly delicate items that you've hand washed and you just need to add conditioner to. The symbol in the middle of the screen is a soak program. So it says, select this program for heavily soiled laundry. Pour the detergent into the compartment marked 1. And it says, this program is not suitable for wool. The machine performs a soak at 30 degrees and stops with the water in the drum. The water can be emptied out by depressing the start/pause button. Important! If the water is not emptied out within 18 hours, the machine empties automatically. At the end of the soak, after having emptied out the water, you can select the washing program. Turn first the program selector dial to 0, and then select the program and depress the start/pause button. The program symbol showing the wash tub with the various dots is for your rinse and spin. So on this program, the machine will perform 3 rinses, followed by a final 1200 RPM spin. But again, of course, we can reduce that spin down to a minimum of 500 if you want to. After checking the instruction book, I've discovered that this symbol here, marked by a star shape, is actually for washing in cold water. So we can do a cold water wash on cotton, on synthetics, and on wool if we so desire. The bio function can be selected for cotton and synthetics with a washing temperature of 40 or more degrees. The machine will maintain a temperature of 40 degrees for about 10 minutes to enable the enzymes contained in the detergent to eliminate the dirt. This can be used for laundry with stubborn stains. Here's the porthole of the washing machine. It's pretty small. I've just checked the instruction book, and the maximum capacity for this particular washing machine is only 4.5 kilograms, which was pretty standard back in the day, but it's pretty small for most washing machines we see nowadays. It does look quite small in there. We've got the rating plate at the top, just out of camera shot. You might just be able to see it. You won't be able to read it, but it's an Italian-made machine, and product number 9145-101-08-02, and it's 2050 watts maximum, which is mainly the heater, I would say, would take up that power. IPX4. So obviously this won't open fully because this is actually situated in a corner. I'm not sure if this opens fully anyway, but it's still opened enough for us to get inside. It is a little bit grubby. I've seen far worse in the seal, but I'm going to give it a good old maintenance wash later, a 95 wash with some biological powder, which will give this a good clean out. Final thing to show you before I set a load going is the fluff filter at the bottom. This is the fluff filter located at the bottom of the machine. Most automatics have some sort of filter to protect the pump from any foreign objects that could cause damage. So it's always important anyway to check your pockets for any coins or any loose objects that can become caught in the filter. But this fluff filter here is designed also to trap fluff as well as any foreign bodies. Now I've already taken this off just to see if any water would come out, and it didn't, fortunately. So it's a bit stiff. I can remember which way to turn it. No, it's anti-clockwise, I think. There we go. It's not too bad. I thought it might be really caked in gunk. It could do with, you know, a bit of a clean. It's a little bit black. That's not too bad. It's not all caught up. If there was any coins or anything, buttons, they would gather in the bottom there and prevent them going into the pump. So I'll pop that back, make sure it's securely tightened. Obviously, if I don't tighten that, the washer will start to leak as soon as it fills with water. So we must make sure that is secure before we start the program. Okay, that's all done. Let's put the washing in. Right, I'm ready to load the laundry. I'm going to do a synthetic program. Despite the fact that most of these items are cotton, I've decided I'm going to do a regular synthetic program with an extra rinse. I'm also going to select the bio function. They're not particularly dirty, but in for a penny, in for a pound. So I've got some underwear, socks, a sweatshirt, a hooded top there, more socks and underwear. When I'm loading a machine, I like to alternate the larger items with the smaller items, just to make sure the load is nicely balanced. The dirtiest thing actually I'm going to be washing is a pair of walking trousers that have got a little bit of mud on the bottom of them. Just check the pockets, see if I've left any £50 notes in there, or any cameras. No, that seems fine. I'll pop the trousers on the top. Now I'm going to use, I think, some liquid detergent using a dispensing ball that goes in the wash. So I'll just fill that and place that at the top of the laundry. So I filled up this dispenser with my concentrated washing liquid. There is also a softener in there as well, so I'm not going to add separate softener, and I didn't bring any with me anyway. So I'll just pop that on the top of the laundry at the back, close the door, and then select the program. So first things first, we'll turn the washing machine on. We're going to have it on a 1200 spin. There's no facilities for drying in this cottage. There's a clothes horse, and it's been quite dry weather, so it will dry on that. So I do still need the maximum spin speed available. We're going for the extra rinse as well, and I think we'll go for bio too, but we'll leave it on the normal program. Okay, I now need to turn the dial to the setting we want, and then I can press the start button. Okay, so I'm going to select a regular 40 degree program on the synthetics. So now I'll just press start. After that rather noisy fill, I'd just like to show you that because of the program I've selected, the maximum spin speed it's going to allow me is 900. If I don't feel that the clothes are dry enough for me at the end of the program, I can always select a separate 1200 spin. So what I think it's just done there is the jet system, which to me it looked like it was recirculating the water in order to dissolve the detergent and really mix it in well. I assume that that's what's happened. If any of you more familiar with the Zanussi jet system can fill me in. It's doing something else now. It's filling up, again, quite noisily. Can you hear me above that noise? It's filling up with some more water. As you can see, the Zanussi jet system feature seems to constantly recirculate the water through the wash, which is a very good idea. I'm wondering if Zanussi machines still do that. Okay, that's where I'm going to leave the washing machine for the time being. I haven't got time to wait here until the load is finished. I am on holiday, so I need to go out and explore the countryside. But so far, I'm pretty impressed with this. I do like the jet system feature, constantly recirculating the water and distributing it into the middle of the wash. That's very good, and it's very quiet, the jet system. This is certainly better than the hot point Aquarius washing machine that I used in my last holiday cottage. Well, I don't know how long this is going to take, so I'm going to leave it, I'm going to close the door, and we'll come back towards the end of the program and have a look at the washing. Well, I'm back. I know some of you will have wanted me to show the rinse and spin, but I'm afraid I had to go out and do things. So it's finished. Anyway, no idea how long it took, but it's only spun on 900, so what I might do is do another spin, because we want to use, yes, it's fairly, it's damp, but it's not sopping. I might get a little bit more water out, so I'll take out the dispenser, and then we're going to select a spin only. So let's have a look. Special programs, turn it to spin. It's selected 1200 by default, and we'll start it going. Thank you. Okay, we can now have a look at the clothes. It's unlocked. And that extra spin, I think, has helped to get them just that little bit drier. Oh, here's the dirtiest thing we washed. Just had a bit of dirt on these walking trousers. Well, that's come clean. Pretty impressed with this old Zanussi. Seems pretty solid. It doesn't move at all when it's spinning. It's relatively quiet. So, as I say, I don't know what modern Zanussi washers are like, but I do seem to remember them in the 80s being pretty solid machines. I think they have a fairly good reputation among the Italian manufacturers. So there we go. That's all the clothes out of the washer, ready to dry. Well, that's the end of my little demonstration of this Zanussi jet system built in. Because it had a slight odour to it, what I'm going to do now, before I leave, is to put the machine on a 95 cotton program intensive with a little bit of detergent. Now, it is best to use a biological powder, but unfortunately I don't have a biological powder with me, so I'll just have to use the liquid. The high temperature will still help to remove the smell. I've just got a non-bio liquid to use. So the best thing to do, if you've got a smelly washing machine, do it empty on the hottest program, hottest, longest program, but with a little bit of biological powder. And you'll find, hopefully, that your odours will be eliminated after running the program on such a high temperature. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to add a bit of the detergent as the machine's filling, and then hopefully this machine will smell a little bit nicer than it did before. So that's the end of this video, another holiday video for you, showing you an old Zanussi jet system washing machine. Thanks for watching, please thumb up this video, please subscribe, and don't forget, please check out all my other videos. So until the next time, bye for now.